Good morning, everyone. The first thing I'd like you to do is to show step. I'd like you to sit up and I'd like you to track me so that you can show your form tutor that you're paying attention. This is a really important assembly and I hope that you'll find sections of it really interesting. I've been really pleased seeing students around the academy using step over the last 3 weeks in lessons, but I need to see this happening more across our academy.
Listen as your day unfolds, challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted, don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser.
So what's the definition of resilience? Resilience is our ability or our capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. Resilience is our ability to bounce back. Sometimes it's useful to look at synonyms for words that we're not familiar with. A synonym is a word that means exactly or nearly the same as another word. So some synonyms for resilience are strength, toughness, elasticity, and flexibility. Some of the characteristics of resilience are independence, being calm under pressure, a rational thought process, so being realistic, self-esteem, which is believing in yourself, optimism, or being hopeful, happiness, and purpose, which is knowing what you're trying to achieve and having goals, which was a tutorial activity that Mrs. Keenan set for you last week.
We all know that life has its ups and downs. Many of us make plans for the future that include the ups, finding a fulfilling career, meeting our true love. But we often don't anticipate the downs in quite the same way. When we're inevitably confronted with life's challenges, some of us appear better equipped to deal with them than others. We bounce back. We swim rather than sink. Bend as opposed to break. This inner strength is resilience. And it's a powerful tool to harness in pursuit of our personal and professional ambitions. Like any skill, resilience can be learned. It just takes some practice. By getting some of the basic foundations right, like sufficient, good quality sleep, moderate exercise, and by giving ourselves some me time, we can set ourselves up to thrive.
Don't Quit by Edgar Albert Guest. Edgar Guest was a British-born American poet who was popular in the first half of the 20th century and became known as the People's Poet. His poems often had an inspirational and an optimistic view of everyday life. This poem has the ideas of resilience running through it.
When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh. When care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit.
Life is queer with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow.
Often the goal is nearer than it seems to a faint and faltering man. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup. And he learned too late when the knight slipped down how close he was to the golden crown.
Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint to the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when you're hardest hit. It's when things seem worst that you must not quit.
I'd like you to watch this short clip from a BBC series called This Is My Life. These are real life stories, and this is Aaron, who's being really brave and sharing some of the challenges he's had to face in his life. You'll see that things have been really difficult for Aaron, but he's begun the journey of bouncing back to make his life as successful as it can be. I think his resilience is really impressive.
My dad have got a heroin addiction. They've had that before I was born. My dad's also an alcoholic, and he has been ever since, from the day I can remember. I've got really, really strict curfews here. So from Monday to Thursday, it's 12 o'clock. And from Friday to Sunday, it's 2 o'clock. And if you're not home by this time, they will be calling the police and you will technically be counted as a missing child. You have to pay for your own gas and electric. As you can see, I don't at the moment because I'm currently out of money. This is all just basic stuff I can just eat to kind of keep me going. So the super noodles and the soup and stuff like that. When you go into a supermarket, you're like, oh, I really want that, but you can't get it because you've got to spend it on someone else. I always look at the cakes and the sweets and the ice cream and stuff like that, but it's just like a distant memory, really.
Who do you think's kind of influenced your work ethic from sort of growing up?
Not having a suitable male role model in my life, it's been quite hard for me to go out and look for a job because no one's like ever spoke to me about it like properly. So I think that having young people that have been through the care system as people to help kids that are now in the care system is a lot. It's going to change kids, maybe see how they see them from now on.
So you think it can be aspirational for young people?
Yeah, inspiration.
And I think in some ways you're also a role model, aren't you?
Exactly. Getting obviously my first ever paycheck is really, really good. I'm very, very proud of myself because I know that I've earned and worked for it. So it's a really big step for me. So as you can see, I've got 802 as my account balance, but my available balance is £756. I've never really seen this type of money really in my life. All right, let's do some shopping. Get myself some ice cream and a few cakes and maybe a few, like, little sweets and stuff like that. Could I have £20 on the gas and £20 on the electric, please?
£40 total.
There you go, thank you very much.
Cheers, man.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
There we go, all back on. I put on a brave face, but sometimes I broke down in front of Lisa last week, because it's just getting too much for me. Like, I'm worried that my parents are gonna one day do what they do and I'm not gonna see them again and stuff like that. So, but hopefully for my sake as well and for them, they'll do what they need to do. Obviously, they haven't really done well with me in the past, but I hope they're proud of me. So. Hopefully there's a lot of good things to come for me in my future. And I'm just ready to face the world with all my mighty strength.
Do you know who Maya Angelou is? To try and sum up Maya Angelou in this assembly is not possible. We'd need much longer, but I would like you to find out about her. Maya Angelou was an American poet and civil rights activist. She had a writing career and creative career that lasted over 50 years. Maya Angelou is best known for her series of autobiographies, which focus on her childhood and early adult life. Her most famous autobiography is called I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, and tells of her life up to the age of 17. Her books center on themes such as racism, identity, and family. Maya Angelou showed incredible strength and resilience as a young woman and throughout her life. Maya Angelou was sexually abused, and following this horrific experience and the events connected with it, she became mute, which means that she didn't speak for almost 5 years. Later on, as a young woman, Maya Angelou began her creative life, and she also campaigned for equal rights for the black community and women at a time when segregation was still legal. Segregation was the socially enforced separation of African American people from white people. So, what does this mean for you? I'd like you to take the quite serious messages from this assembly about resilience and think about how you can apply them to your everyday life. This might be at home, with your friends and family, and crucially for us, it might be in school and with your schoolwork and learning. How do you react to setbacks? Do you always do your best? Are you calm when something goes wrong? Do you believe that you can overcome the barrier you are faced with if you endeavour and if you persist? Thank you for listening carefully this morning, and I look forward to seeing you around the Academy this week. Make sure you're showing step, and I want to talk to you about how you're showing resilience with your learning and with your lives in school. Have a good week.